hair. Give this maddened man a little consolation. Give a little consolation to the moth fallen in your flame. Beloved, do not forget to visit in the nights of separation. I long to smell the fragrance of your locks. Give a little consolation. Separation butchered my heart to blood with the dagger of helplessness. Oh, beloved, this blood itself weeps for union. Give a little consolation. Constant restlessness in your separation has become my tragic life. Intensify it beyond endurance. Allow me to die, or give a little consolation. The stains of all wants have been washed away by drinking my heart's blood. Oh, beloved, what am I passing through in your love? Give a little consolation. Oh, Bhau, for years I've been begging my beloved for death. To gain life from death, the beloved must come and give a little consolation. O Meher, though you are eternally present, and I feel your presence in my heart, I miss your beautiful smile, and I miss your loving embrace. Oh, beloved, I long to see your beautiful face. But how can I see in the dark night? Only purity can light the lamp of love in my heart to see your face. Oh, beloved, you dropped your physical form, and my heart broke into pieces. And though painful, I find that this life is worth living because each piece of my heart longs to drink a cup of your presence. Oh, friends, please do not ask me how I lead my life nowadays. I long to embrace my death, and the beloved tells me to wait, and I am waiting. Oh, brothers and sisters, how can I explain what type of life I lead in the company of my beloved? Sometimes my smile appears as tears, and sometimes my tears appear as a smile. Oh, people of the world, you have not the slightest idea of my life with the beloved, and you think that I lead a painfully miserable life. I tell you that the happiness derived from all the wealth and comforts of the world is nothing before the joy one receives from a little pain of longing for the beloved. Oh, Bhau, do not forget that you have not yet enjoyed the slightest breeze of the path, and your head is not yet bent down completely at the feet of the beloved. Therefore, long to become a true slave of the beloved and use only the language befitting a slave. O Meher, why did you throw me into this cauldron of pain? Why did you leave me alone in a forest full of nightmares? I went to your garden convinced I would find peace of mind, but your wind-blown locks captured my heart in a prison of pain. The wound of my heart was deep. I wept with anguish. You sprinkled salt on my wounds and thus showered your mercy on me. My dust was weeping after drinking the blood of my heart. Why couldn't you make its death easy for me to bear? When I did not love you, I was filled with desires, but at least I was happy. Now, I realize that these desires have kept me bound for ages on end. I thought your behavior with me was friendly, but you were actually preparing me for my death. How can I ever tell you what I've found in this path? I was a beggar. Your love made me a king. This life is life when it becomes love. And this love makes a man become God. What use is life drowned in the allurements of the world? The desires of lust only made me a devil. Pain is now my cure and constant companion. By killing me, you showered your sweet grace. It isn't easy to follow you, then stay with you. Bhau surrendered his life only because of your grace.